Is holding back a great strategy in relationships? That's the conversation we're going to have here today on Relationship Thursday. How you guys doing? This is Ron Simplified Myers, author, podcaster, and your uplifting life partner. Now, I've listened to a lot of gurus talk about how you should behave inside of a relationship in terms of, especially in the dating when you're first starting to date. It has been taught more and more that you should give a little and see what the person brings to you and then give them a little bit more. Now, my thing is, I always tell people, think about this. If you're giving a little bit inside of your relationship, do you think the other person is picking up on that? And we all know the answer to that is, of course they do. And if you're giving half or a portion of yourself, what are they going to do in return? Or if it's you in that situation, what are you going to do in return if you feel like the person is not giving to the relationship, not giving their all? You're not going to give your all. So this relationship is definitely headed in the wrong direction. This is why I'm not a person that's into playing games. I tell people you need to be honest, upfront, authentic. That's just the way you have to be in your relationships. I know it's scary. I know it's one of those you're putting your heart out there. We just talked about heartbreak. Nobody wants to deal with that or have to go through that. If you've had it done before, I know it's really scary. And for a lot of people, this is probably a good conversation here that have had heartbreak because they're scared to go out here and do it again because of that. And they're more likely to do what I just said, and that's they're going to put their toe in a little bit, test the waters, let me see where they're coming from, let me see what they're all about. Folks, you have to be able to give it all. I've used the analogy, if you got to get to the top of the hill of a mountain, there's no way you're going to get there if you're at the bottom of the mountain and you sitting there contemplating on, okay, I think I'm going to go. Well, I'm going to go maybe up the hill just a little bit, and I'm going to stop, I'm going to look around, I'm going to weigh it. Folks, it's going to take forever for you to get up that hill if you ever get there. The thing is, you got to go. You just got to make it happen. And it's the same thing in relationships. One thing for sure, when you show who you are, and those that know me or that have met me through social media will tell you, what you see is what you get. That's me. I don't change. If you like me on video, then you'll like me in person because it's going to be the same person. If you don't like me on video, you're not going to like me in person. It's still going to be the same person because I believe in being me all the time. I had someone even share with me, they said the thing I love about you is the stories you've told in the past, you still tell it the same way. And I shared with them, I said, because when you're authentic and you're speaking your truth, you don't have to remember what you did or what you said, because that's why your story's going to stay the same, because you don't have to try to remember what you said. And to me, that's the same thing. I don't want to act a certain way or have to put on a front trying to remember what I did, didn't do, what I told you, because I gave you a part of the story. What part of the story did I? I don't want to play those games. This is what you're going to get. You're going to get all of Ron. If you run, good. And I'm hoping you do it quickly. I shared with you guys the story of the young lady in the car that was telling me, you know, that it got in a guy's phone number. She wanted to call him, and her friends went into coach mode and was telling her why she shouldn't call him, and all these different games they were trying to teach her to play. And I just laughed, and I said, and they were like, why are you laughing? And I said, because you're playing games. If you play games, you attract people that play games. And it's hard to figure out those that are playing games. Why? Because you're playing them. So you don't know if they're being authentic. But here's the key, and that's what I told her. If you feel in your heart you want to call him. And if you scare him, good. You can get rid of him tonight. Your friends are trying to tell you a 2 to 3 week plan. You ain't got 2 to 3 weeks to play with. None of us, as we know, there's nothing is promised. So why waste 2 to 3 weeks if you really want to know? Make that call tonight if that's what you want to do. Now, I know some ladies will disagree and go, well, women shouldn't be that aggressive. To each his own. If you're a woman that don't want to do that, don't do it. She was a woman that's planning on calling him. My thing is, I told her, why are you waiting if it's on your heart? That's why I told her, if it's on your heart, then do it. If there's some driving you, then make the call. And then you play it from there. And you guys know I've shared that before, too, about, you know, when people say the woman, that the guy should be the aggressor. Almost every case, without an exception, it's the woman. Because remember, she's the one that gets to say yes or no. So even if he was the aggressor, she says no, bye-bye. If she says yes, then the relationship blossoms. So, but the woman is the one that's usually, and I've always shared this, guys will not walk across the room to talk to a woman unless she's giving them the wink. She stares at him, but she makes it comfortable for him that he feels like, I won't get rejected. And that's really the key. That's why I've even shared with young ladies, if you're in a crowded area, a crowded place, and the guy's across the room that you're attracted to, you better move closer if you're wanting him to speak to you, because there's very few guys that will walk all the way across the room and speak to you, even if he's interested, unless you've given him those winks, those stares or whatever. And that is called initiating contact. I don't know why, for some reason in our society, we think that because he spoke first, he's quote unquote the hunter. No, he got hunted. But anyway, bottom line is, my whole point of this video is, whatever you're going to do in your relationships, be you, however that is, if you're the initiator or if you're not. Let people see you in every situation and all your relationships. That way there's no guessing. Those that are supposed to be in your life will stay there because the fact is they understand you, they agree with where you're heading, and those that don't, good. And the sooner we can recognize that they don't want to be around us, the sooner we can let them go. And especially in a relationship, the faster we figure this out, the faster we can move on. But never, ever go into a relationship sticking your toe in the water, playing games, and then wonder why your relationship is always, I don't know what's going on. I don't know what he's thinking. I don't know what she's thinking. Because you started it off wrong. Be authentic. Be you. As I said, take me as I am. And then we'll see where this goes. And as you guys know, it ain't right. It ain't wrong. It is my opinion. Now, for those of you on Self Love Monday, we'll talk to you on Monday. And then for those for Relationship Thursday, we'll see you back here next week. Run over to RonSimplifiedMyers.online. Again, that's RonSimplifiedMyers.online. Check out all the things that I got going on. And remember, folks, if you're not having fun, you should be doing something else. Don't play games. Most important thing you can do in any relationship, including the one with the person in the mirror, is to be you. All the time, 24/7, 365 days a year. I'll talk to you guys soon. Take care. Bye-bye.